Hello students, welcome to another lecture that is on the chapter number 2, that is on energy storage. So until now we have almost seen all the batteries that can be used for the electric vehicle and the hybrid electric vehicles as well. We saw about the working and the pros and cons of those batteries, how those batteries work, which type of electrodes and which type of electrolytes are used on those batteries. So we have seen all the things about the batteries that we saw. The battery that is remaining to be learned is a lithium ion battery. Right, that lithium ion battery is the most widely used battery since the adoption of the battery from 1991. That battery has gained the interest from all the electric vehicle manufacturers, and that lithium ion battery is generally used in the wide applications of the electric vehicles as well as hybrid electric vehicles as well. So let's see what is the basic difference of the lithium ion battery and why it is known as the lithium ion battery. Now the lithium ion battery is known as the lithium ion because the ions of the lithium will be going towards to and fro during discharging and charging process, and the ion will continuously go through the electrolyte of the battery, and because of the movement of the continuous lithium ions, it is known as the lithium ion battery. Right, so you can see a simple figure of the lithium ion batteries. In the case of the lithium ion, you can see that the positive electrode is kept as the lithiated transition metal intercalation oxide, right, that is Li1-X metal, that is My and OZ. The XYZ will be decided based on the value of the X that we are keeping for the negative electrode. That negative electrode is lithiated carbon intercalation material that is being intercalated with the carbon, right, that is LiXC. So one component of lithium will be lesser in case of the positive electrode compared to the negative electrode, right. You can see that in positive negative electrode LiX is used, in negative in positive electrode it is used Li1-X. Now at the positive electrode we will require a current collector that is kept as aluminium, and at the negative electrode we have kept the copper current collector, right. The current collector will be there in almost all the batteries, right. We have not seen that, but that current collector will be there according to the requirement. The different materials will be used for the current collector. In the case of the lithium ion battery, the electrolyte will be of the solid polymer type electrolyte, that is of an organic solution. Organic, which means the hydrocarbon, right. So that organic solution solid electrolyte will be used in the case of the lithium ion battery. Now the procedure for the discharging and charging, you can see that lithium carbon intercalation, like that is LiXC plus Li1-X MyOZ, will be converted into the carbon, will be along the lithium ion from the negative electrode will go towards the positive electrode, and it will create a lithium, that is one lithium, that because 1-X, that is lithium, and MyOZ. So in that case the lithium is gone from negative to positive electrode. During the charging process the lithium will go from positive to negative electrode. So this is how the lithium ions go to and fro during the discharging and charging process, and this is simply how lithium ion battery works. Now why it is widely used? Because it has a certain amount of advantages, such as the it has a highest rated voltage in case of all the batteries, that is 4 volt per cell. Also the specific energy of this battery is around 200 watt hour, right, per kg, and also it has a better cyclic life, that is almost 1000. The only disadvantage this battery has is the self discharging rate, which is around 10%. right? It self-discharges if the vehicle is not being used, and that is the only disadvantage this battery has. And also to reduce that, again, some developments are being carried right now as well, and in the future we can also assume that this can also be reduced as well. So this lithium-ion battery is right now the most widely and most common choice for the electric vehicles. So these were all the batteries that can be used. Now let's see the evolution of the batteries throughout from the times that we are using the batteries. First one is VRLA, that is our lithium ion battery, valve regulated lithium lead acid battery, right? So in case of the lead acid battery, you can see all the components have been shown: specific energy, energy density, specific power, cycle life, and the projected cost, right? You can see all the specific energy of the batteries here. Just look at the lithium ion battery. The specific energy is comparatively good compared to the air battery. It has very lower cost, but air batteries has a disadvantage of mechanical charging. So because of that, lithium ion has around 130 watt hour per kg. Energy density is also good, that is 140 to 200. Also specific power, that is also very good, that is 250 to 450. Right, so it is giving the combination of the energy as well as the power compared to other batteries. The cycle life that you can see is around 800 to 1200. Right, so the cycle life is almost maximum that a battery can provide, and the projected cost is also comparatively in budget. Right, it is not the lowest, but it is in budget, because the advantages it provides compared to other batteries is good. So we can give a little bit extra cost, but you can see that it is also cheaper compared to the sodium beta batteries, also cheaper compared to the nickel metal hydride batteries, right? The nickel metal hydride was the best from nickel batteries, and it is comparatively costlier. But compared to that, our lithium ion batteries is little bit cheaper depending on the requirement. So this is how the batteries has evaluated, the number of batteries options has used, the development is done, and the energy and power that we have obtained until now can be seen from here. Also, you can see here the comparison of the batteries, right? The comparison and the potential in the long term or near term, if it is very good or not. The first one is the VRLA, that is valve regulated lead acid battery. So the advantages and disadvantages we can see here is that the lead acid battery is mature, it has low cost, it is fast rechargeable, high specific power, and the disadvantage is its low specific energy, right? So the range will be lower. In the near term, it has a very high potentiality, it can be evaluated if we work on it. Second one is the nickel cadmium battery. It is mature again, it is fast rechargeable, high specific power, right? The disadvantages are its high cost and low specific energy. Once again, in the near term, it has a high potential in it. Next is nickel zinc battery, high specific energy, high specific power, low cost, and the short cycle life because of the zinc electrode problem. In the medium term, it has a high potentiality. Next is nickel metal hydride. In the case of the high specific energy, high specific power, is fast rechargeable. The only disadvantage is the high cost that we saw in the previous slide. So it has a near term very high potentiality, because in the near term we can get pretty much very developments that can be required. The zinc air battery, the mechanical rechargeable, it is low cost, very high specific energy. The disadvantages are low specific power and cannot accept the regenerative energy, right? Because it is not electrically charged, so regenerative energy will not be accepted in this battery. In the medium term, it will take some time for the high potentiality. In the case of the aluminium air, again, the mechanical rechargeable, it has low cost, also it is very high specific energy, low specific power, it cannot again get the regenerative energy because it is not electrically charged. In the near term, it has very low potentiality because of the disadvantages. Next is the sodium sulfur. That is high specific energy, high specific power, high cost is disadvantage. Safety concerns are there in case of the sodium sulfur, and also it needs a thermal management. Because of that, in the medium term, it has a moderate potentiality. There are lesser chances of it getting successful. Next is sodium and nickel chloride. That is high specific energy, the only advantage. The disadvantages are high cost and again need of thermal management. In the medium term, it can have a higher potentiality. The lithium polymer battery, it has very high specific energy, high specific power. Only disadvantage is weak low temperature performance. In the medium term, it has high potentiality. Lithium ion, that is the last. That it has very high specific energy, high specific power, only the cost is comparatively higher. It has very high potentiality at a medium term time. So these are the basic comparison of all the batteries that we saw about the electric and hybrid vehicles, right? The potentiality that can arise in the future about these batteries as well. So we have almost seen about all the batteries of the EVs and hybrid electric vehicles. Now these batteries have some common disadvantage, that is the energy or the range of the vehicle is still at lower, and we have to compromise between power and specific energy. So to avoid that, there are options of the hybridization of the energy. We are either using two energy sources in the electric vehicle, or we are trying to use two energy sources. We will see alternate energy sources that can be used in combination of our batteries as well in the next video, the ultra capacitor and the flywheels. Until then, thank you so much.